of our determination to be free. This is the principle of the march, and certainly we intend to keep this march nonviolent.
Mr. Carmichael, are you as committed to the nonviolent approach as Dr. King is?
No, I'm not.
Why aren't you?
Well, I just don't see it as a way of life. I never have. But I also realize that no one in this country is asking the white community in the South to be nonviolent. And that, in a sense, is giving them a free license to go ahead and shoot us at will.
Le mouvement de King se faisait rapidement dépasser par une faction du mouvement Black Power, plus jeune et plus combative. Le mouvement perdait de son unité. La communauté noire s'était fédérée contre la ségrégation. Mais une fois la ségrégation disparue, il fallait se demander ce que nous voulions vraiment.
I would like for all of us to believe in non-violence, but I'm here to say tonight that if every Negro in the United States turns against non-violence, I'm going to stand up as a lone voice and say this is the wrong way. Martin Luther King Jr. was killed tonight in Memphis, Tennessee. Shot in the face as he stood on the balcony of his hotel room.
Martin était mort. Et avec lui, une grande partie du mouvement. On savait que notre combat ne serait plus jamais le même. Mais les choses pour lesquelles nous nous étions battus étaient en partie gagnées.
I just want to do God's will. And he's allowed me to go up to the mountain. And I've looked over. And I've seen the promised land. I may not get there with you. But I want you to know tonight that we as a people will get to the promised land. So I'm happy tonight. I'm not worried about anything. I'm not fearing any man. My eyes have seen the glory of the coming of the Lord.
We had...
Nous avions tout donné pour ce mouvement. Nous avions accepté la paix et la non-violence comme principe et comme mode de vie.